Hello everyone, here we are back for the next lesson. So today the plan will be actually to input the shoulders action inside of the alt swing we've seen in the last exam. So let's see how it works. The whole story of this swing is actually to keep a complete connection between the top, every different part of the top of your body. So we're first trying to visualize all the shoulders, arms and club and wrists especially walk together into the way back and how they're supposed to stay connected. But we're gonna check that in a straight position, and then we're gonna apply the same motion into the posture we learned before. So let's see how we're gonna move. I'm gonna start with my club in front of myself, fully straight. We learned before that the wrist's gonna play the first move. We know that the elbow bring the club in line with my shoulder plane. Now, it should be moved more than that. So what happened is, this move is actually connected with the lifting action of my feet. This lifting action of my left feet, so the motion of my knees going up and back, front and back, it's actually making my whole body easily to turn. So I'm gonna get myself here somewhere, turning my back to the shoulders. So create the end motion, get my elbow, same time, let my feet move so I can turn. We can see now that I'm actually completely turning my back to the target. My body is actually quite turned to the back. From there, we'll just hit the ground with the feet, everything will come back, forearms and club will unfold, and we're gonna just keep moving. So now trying to reach the mid-swing posture, the half-swing position. Again, straight, hand to my belt, bend down, kick the knees in order to get my right hand on the club. So we're gonna play the L swing. Here I am. Now from there, I want to set the club to the top. So what happened is I was just keeping my swing center stable. I'm gonna just turn my shoulders around my spine, bringing my left shoulders under the ball. We see that this shoulder is not moving that much. It's actually like a little 45 degrees onto the way back, and my thumb actually just push onto the plane and to the top. From this position, all my body weight is actually sitting onto my right side. My muscles from the back of muscles are completely stretched here somewhere without having to be manipulated. So it's stretched, but it's still in line compared to the top part of my body, compared to my spine actually. I don't want to trying to create any torsion in it. It's actually the same feeling than just turning yourself like this to speak to someone which is on your side, except the fact that you're gonna keep your head, keep looking in front of yourself. Quite hard if you keep both feet and legs stuck in the ground. But in our swing, we know that we're gonna just stepping onto the heel from your right side, picked up the left heel, and it's gonna just give ourselves an easy turn to the right. Now from there, I can just, it's quite relaxed actually. The muscles will be tense mainly by the transition on my spine and accelerate by that motion. Now, there's some fault you can make when you reach that top motion and you're trying to play the club, and some of you certainly have this problem sometimes, that they just getting the ball to the left or hitting too much on the ball instead of having that nice launch angle and the high ball fly that the mass swing is supposed to create. It will be due mainly to the fact that if you reach the top of your backswing, and then from there, I'm just thinking of hitting the ball. Hitting the ball is enough to just activating the top of your body. My thought when I start my downswing is actually to hit the ground with my left heel. I'm actually focusing. I'd like to hear that my feet hitting the ground before I'm actually hitting the ball. It's actually a sign for me that my weight has been transferred from one side to the other. Of course, assuming the fact that my right heel have to be lift at the same time I hit the ground with my left one. Otherwise, the machine is stuck, your shoulders move over. If everything takes place in the correct order, your shoulders will be just tracked by your spine. Your club will be released, the muscles you stretch into the back of your right arms will just unfold and reach the impact. The speed increase, of course, not because I'm trying to creating the speed with the muscles in my back, just because keeping my head on the ball, I just let the spine having the circle and having the club into the plane bring back to the ball. So I'd like to visualize this 7 between my left arms and my shoulders, which is quite clear if I'm when I'm making the first move here. Now if I'm playing the club also, and we said that before, I just keep that 7 so we can see that it's still there. And it's gonna stay the same by the time I'm turning my shoulders. It's gonna as well stay the same if I'm correctly hit the ground with my feet. Still the same. My right arm is actually completely relaxed, and it just releases the clubs through the motion. I just have set, drop, under, step right, get your shoulders in line, so my shoulders actually just under my chin. From there, the passenger is actually sitting in a train. I'm just thinking of not hitting the ball, but hitting the ground with my feet, and it will create the first impulsion, which actually releases the club through the impact area. There we go. So, next video will be actually onto the outside area. So I'm gonna hit some ball, trying to show you some different angle on a goal swing, and give you some more explanation about a different fault you can make into this swing. I already give you a couple of keys that you can use to correct yourself. The goal of the mass swing is actually to give you complete understanding on the way your body is supposed to work, and not only give you an understanding on it, but give you the possibility to just correct it by yourself. Sometimes you need someone to look at you, that's for sure. But a lot of things which actually be controlled by your own first impulsion. So the first impulsion you're gonna give will create a complete motion into your body, which is actually not something you're trying to control. If you take control on the part which is supposed to be a reaction, you're gonna create some problems. We see that with the shoulders, huh? From the top, if I'm bringing the club to the top and then if I'm trying to turn my shoulders, of course they're gonna turn when I'm hit the ball. But if I'm trying to turn them instead of just thinking of hitting the ground with these feet, the whole motion will be transformed and my spine angle will change. It's going to be the same for the mid part of your body if you reach the top of your swing correctly. And now, instead of thinking of my feet, I know that my hips will move in a certain way. But if I'm trying to move my hips, nothing happens. I'm still stuck into my right leg. If I'm trying to use my shoulders, as I said before, they're going to move over. The only key to go back is hit your feet. My shoulders drop down, natural release, hit ball on my side, job done. So, I hope it's gonna help you. Feel free to ask any question you have. Hit hard, keep learning, it's the key.